Hi, I'm Richa. On Quirqstation, you can find my shop by the name of Richa Kedia. I'm a chemical engineer by qualification and I worked in the corporate sector for quite a number of years. But art and nature were always a passion. So I pursued them over the weekends, but then ultimately I reached a point where I did not only wanted it to be a weekend activity, I wanted it to occupy all my time, and I also wanted to take it to the world to get the ideas across, to see, to show the world what I see in nature and what inspires me in nature. And that is when I decided to pursue this full time. I quit my job and now I'm a freelancer in art and graphic design, but and also create a lot of products which you can see on my shop. Especially birds are a constant source of inspiration. I spend a lot of time going in the field, birding. Like, you can leave me any day, the whole day, I'll just look at birds, stare at them, because they're so interesting. Like, each bird has its own story to tell, and their breeding habits, their the way the male attracts the female. Like, every bird is unique in its own way, and the more you delve into them, the more you, I mean, more details you get to learn about them. And I mean, I don't get bored somehow, as in, I know it sounds like, what are you doing? Like, there are many people who come and ask me, what are you doing? You're just sitting and looking at birds. But it's very fascinating for me. I can actually do that all day, and I'm a very restless person otherwise. So if you actually leave me in a room and tell me to do something, I can't do that. But you leave me outdoors, and I can just stare at trees, hug them, look at birds, look at them playing around. I'll just be chasing one after the other. And that's what always inspired me. And that is what I normally try and bring it out on canvas, experimenting more. Even other mammals and trees are something which are fascinating. So I keep looking at that also. But yeah, birds are the best, the most inspiring, and so that's how I think most of my works are dedicated towards birds. My idea behind my shop also is, as I want to bring whatever I see, the knowledge that I see, to the world. And climate change is a reality, and the way we are growing, we're just focusing on development and we're moving away from nature. So the further we move away from nature, that's just going to be detrimental for the human race. So the closer we get back to nature, I think it's going to be beneficial for the planet, for the human race overall. And this is the message I'm trying to convey to my through my works. I'm trying to bring awareness about various aspects of nature to everyone, especially the kids. So I also do learning sessions with the kids, wherein, you know, they actually get to appreciate nature more. And that's all my works are also based on the same principle, and hopefully the word does get spread around through the works that I'm doing. I quit my job in 2017, and then I was commissioned by resorts like Pagdandi Safaris and Singiri Nava Lodge in Madhya Pradesh for bird paintings. And there also the idea was that there should be a painting, but it should also tell something specific about the bird to whoever is viewing it. So those original paintings are still in display at the various resorts, and that led me to the idea that the original painting is at one place, but then I still want to spread the word about the birds to everyone. And hence, as in, I started doing other products like calendars, bookmarks, postcards, greeting cards, etc. So all of them generally have the painting of the bird or the mammal or tree that I have done, and also brief detail about it, which gets a person interested. So again, you know, spreading the word about it. Challenges have been many. I don't know where to start, but to begin with, the biggest challenge, of course, is to leave a stable job and a stable income and then switch to the art side and make your living out of it. And I have no financial support from anyone else, so I have to be independent. And that is the biggest challenge, which is still continuing, though it gets better with time. The even work-wise, yes, finding the bird itself is a challenge because like I want to see the bird before painting it. Like if I paint from a picture, it doesn't give the same effect. So finding the bird, I've painted the rarest of birds. I've gone to different parts of the country, bustard. I've gone to Rajasthan for tragopan and monal. I've made trips to Himachal and Uttarakhand. I mean, multiple times. So finding the bird, going out of seeing it in the wild, that itself is a big challenge because and the bird is not cooperative. It's not like a very good model that will just be sitting out for you. And especially in the wild, it's just there. So sometimes you might be spending days and not getting a sight of the bird at all. Sometimes it just comes to you in the first instant itself. So you don't know the time that you would be spending on the field. And considering that art itself requires a lot of time, the painting requires a lot of time. You always, the time is always a challenge, and I'm a one-man show, so then managing time is again one of the biggest challenges. I don't know how to divide it because birding is a time-consuming task, art is a time-consuming task. If I'm designing or if I also take up client projects, that again is a time-consuming task. So yeah, dividing my time is a challenge. Marketing takes up a lot of time, so fortunately Quirqstation has been of immense help there. Before, I had to concentrate a lot of my time on the marketing, talking to people one-on-one, through word of mouth, so my friend circle, so on and so forth. Quirqstation has obviously taken off a lot of my load on that front. The marketing has become a lot easier, shipping has become a lot easier. So fortunately, I have more bandwidth to spend on my art and on birding. The process begins with research. I like reading a lot. I like delving a lot of details about the subject that I want to paint. And there is a lot to study about nature. It is then followed by fieldwork, wherein I actually make trips to the wild and see the subject in the wild, again observe it, make sketches and take photographs as many as I can. Next step is that I would do the composition of the painting initially, again rough sketches, then followed by the final painting in watercolor in acrylic. Most of my works are in watercolor. After the painting is complete and I'm satisfied with it, which itself is a difficult task to achieve, that's when I digitalize it in different mediums. It can be a postcard, a calendar. I'm still experimenting with other mediums which are reachable to people and which people can access and use. Because art is for everyone, it should be available in different formats. And that is the idea, that I then digitalize it and make it available in different formats for people. Experience with Quirqstation has been great. It is a great platform for makers like me who have handcrafted products and want to reach out to a bigger audience. It takes away a lot of your bandwidth, which is required in marketing and, again, reaching out to a wider audience, because there's as much as you can do through your own contacts and through your own network. So this gives you a broader network. It helps you a lot in any way possible to grow your business. So I look forward to growing on the platform. I look forward actually to increasing my product range also. So I would be working on that. Hopefully you would also see that and enjoy the products that I have to offer. The message I have for all of you, and I'm trying to spread the message even through my works, is please respect nature as much as you can. This is the need of the hour, and that's only how we can survive in the world today. So thank you for watching this video, and please do check out my shop. Hope you like the products.